European leaders are holding crisis talks on how to deal with the large numbers of migrants risking their lives to cross the Mediterranean Sea. EU member states have started committing more resources for search and rescue missions and are expected to pledge extra spending. The summit comes after an estimated 800 people died making the crossing on Sunday, the worst capsizing on record. Earlier, funerals for 24 of the victims were held in Malta. The number of people fleeing war and poverty in the Middle East and Africa has risen sharply in recent months. More than 35,000 are thought to have crossed from Africa to Europe this year, and some 1,750 have died while attempting the journey. Migrant crisis updates. The summit in Brussels will discuss a 10-point action plan to prevent more deaths, including increasing Frontex's resources and extending the EU's Mediterranean Rescue Service. A pilot project to offer 5,000 places for resettlement for migrants qualifying for protection has also been mooted. Other proposals circulated ahead of the EU meeting include systematic efforts to identify, capture, and destroy vessels before they are used by traffickers, fingerprinting all migrants, and aiding the formation of a stable government in Libya. I hope that in the coming days we'll have a roadmap. We have a great deal to do in this area, German Chancellor Angela Merkel said ahead of the meeting. It's a matter of European values, it's of supreme importance. The UK, in the past a leading advocate of reducing naval patrols, pledged helicopter carrier HMS Bulwark, 2 patrol boats and 3 helicopters to boost search and rescue efforts. Belgium has also offered a navy ship. But senior UN officials have described the EU plan as minimalist and called for creation of legal channels for safe migration, including for low-skilled migrant workers. The proposals are a rehash of what we've heard in the past, said Maltese Prime Minister Joseph Muscat. What's different is there's more political willingness. The EU had been criticized over the scope of Triton, its Mediterranean Rescue Service, which replaced the larger Italian Operation Mare Nostrum last year. Some EU members had said Mare Nostrum was too expensive and expressed concerns that it was encouraging more migrants. However, human rights group Amnesty International said the decision to end Mare Nostrum had contributed to a dramatic increase in migrant and refugee deaths. The EU response to one of the worst refugee crises since World War II has been appalling, said Amnesty's UK director, Kate Allen. Europe has a bigger role to play than just closing its borders. European Parliament President Martin Schulz said EU institutions had tried to act on the issue, but policy decisions were ultimately made by member states. Italian prosecutors gathering witness testimony said the migrants who took the boat that capsized on Sunday had been kept on a farm outside the Libyan capital, Tripoli, for up to a month before embarking, and had paid smugglers $700 to $7,000. £465 to £4,465 each. The prosecutors have accused the suspected Tunisian captain of allowing the boat to crash into a merchant ship that had come to rescue it.